Hello everybody, this is John Crow again, and in this tutorial I wanted to just expand a little bit on doors and quests. So again, this is not really a lot of new information, but it's just kind of different ways of thinking about it. And as I kind of process what I learned during the game jam, a lot of opportunities present themselves to you after the fact. Hindsight being 2020, of course. In the example here, if I go up to the door, we get the standard story to collect a key if you want to open it. So, key. And so I've got a key here with this classic tag. And when I walk up to the door now, open it and I can go through. In the case of this one here, this one I can just open up straight away. So even if I was to reload the game and not collect the key, it just opens. So in order to set up that behavior, we can really have anything trigger that door. In this case, I thought maybe it would make more sense to treat it from the perspective of a kid that wants to go outside, and maybe it's cold out, it's winter here in Vancouver, or coming winter anyways. I've never seen it for snowfall yet, but I've got a standard door behavior on here, so I haven't changed anything yet. I still have the indicator. And I'm going to actually delete the second message required, and I'm going to leave it to interact. So if you have the key to the door, or you have the hat you want to wear, or your parents want you to wear, or your mom wants to be aware before you go outside, that will still allow you to go up and interact with the door and play the standard of those animations. So what I did to make this work was I essentially set up a rule. So I came in here and set up a rule based on actual quest itself called Open That Door. And when I opened that up, I had a standard automatic unlock for the quests themselves. And for the quest counter, I'm collecting objects, and you know, the kind of go-to is the key, capital K, and I learned a lot about tagging objects and just making sure your tags are correct. When I collect one key, the quest auto-completes, and what's most important in this case, it sends a message, and that message is to unlock the door. So in our case, we're going to use the same example, but we're going to adjust it to like a hat that the parent wants the kid to wear. So let's set the tag here to Tam, because that's exactly what that is. And as long as we collect an item with the Tam tag, it's going to trigger the door.unlock message that we're going to send over to the toggle behavior. Keep the door behavior the way it is. Everything looks good there. And I'm going to add a component to the door. And I'm going to add the toggle behavior component. The behavior itself should probably be turned off initially. If it's turned on in our initial state, I'm going to be able to walk right up to the door and I'm going to be able to open it, which I don't want. I want something other than me to have to be an unlocker for it to me to open it. So if I was to select the door on the toggle behavior, turn its state off, then the door is locked now. And in my case, the door actually needs a toggle message in order to turn it on. So if I edit it, there's not really a lot more I can do with the toggle behavior. Again, after all, its job is to simply turn on or off, on or off this actual door behavior. So to be able to actually interact with it, I need to activate it. So back on the toggle behavior, the toggle message that's going to unlock it is going to come from the rule that we set. And if you remember in the rule, in that open door, we have the TAM being collected, which sends a message, door.unlocked. I keep duplicating this when I go into my draw tool. So let's get that message sent. So we need to actually use the door.unlocked as our toggle message. That's what's going to unlock the door. And in order to do that, we need to first of all collect an item that has the tag TAM. So I just added the capital T-A-M tag. It's a Rastafari hat, head cover. And that's going to trigger the opening of the door. And you know, the parent is going to be pleased, I guess, that they have it. So we're going to set this as a collectible, which it is. And I'm also going to send the collect message. Let's call that collect.tem. We're going to keep a coin when we collect that, and we have to interact with it to collect it. But when we use the collect.tem message to get sent out, let's also use it to, maybe we bring in Mother here. Maybe I'll bring in Kaya. She's just kind of standing sternly right there. And we could add a component to her, maybe a speaker component, and we could wait for the message collect.tem and have her respond to it by saying, you know, you can go out now. Your head's warm. And that should work. And it would be neat actually to set up another subtree or sub behavior in here where she's basically standing at the door when you don't have the hat and suggesting you're not going outside until you put it on. But let's see what that does. So here, so she's just not letting me out. She's just, you can't go outside there, buddy. You're not getting out. Go put your hat on. I put the hat on. So you can then see now it triggers. You can go out now, your head's warm. And fortunately, oh, there we go. I can go in and out of that door now. So that's just kind of a neat aspect of the behavior itself. If I wanted to set up a speech pattern where going up to the door would trigger some kind of response suggesting I need to have the hat first, that would be a different set of behaviors, and cover that in a different tutorial. But in summary, we have our TAM collectible. It's got the TAM set of tags. That set of tags is what we're using here as one of the collected items to fulfill a quest. And once we have that collected item, the success completion of the quest sends a message to unlock the door. That gets used in a toggle behavior. The toggle behavior itself is applied to the door as a component, and all it does is toggle the door.unlocked behavior that we set. The default is false, and once we toggle that behavior, it sets the flag to true, and once it's true, then that above behavior, the door behavior, is now accessible to the user. Again, if I play that through, go to the door, it doesn't work, I collect it, and it's good to go. I like it. Nice hat. My E key is supposed to be sticking or something. There we go. I've noticed in all the typing and hammering of keys in VoxEdit over the last while that my keyboard is completely worn out, and I had to be really careful with some of my tags because some of the words wouldn't complete. And that E looks like it is one of my culprits. Anyways, that's just a little extra kind of take on the door and key example. Hope you were able to take something away from it. My name is the John Crow, and I'll talk to you later.